Divine dominion. Divine dominion. I am completing on what Daktari spoke yesterday. I know some of you ever got a chance to watch the show. Those who watched, you know what the woman of God said. So, divine dominion is the title of that sermon. And so, when the woman of God was in the mountain for those 10 days, she was there and she was speaking to God. And there is something about prayer that I want you to understand. Prayer is not a monologue. Prayer is a dialogue. By that I mean, prayer, Sami, is not only you talking to God. It is also God talking back to you. Effective prayer is when you come and speak to God and God speaks back to you. That is when you have prayed. Never allow yourself to leave the prayer altar without God speaking to you. Am I talking to somebody? Naongea na mtu siku ya leo. Usiwahi toka mahali pa maombi kama Mungu hajafanya nini? Hajakunenea. God speaks. It is to you to understand how he speaks and to listen to his voice. I was praying on Monday. On Monday, by the grace of God, in the night hour, God allowed me to tarry a bit longer in the place of prayer. And as I was praying and calling upon God and making my request known to him and bringing my supplications to him, God spoke to me. And he told me things I may not be able to share here because they are a bit personal. But he told me, my son, do this and do this and do that. When it gets to morning by 11 a.m., ensure that you have done this and this and that. Bwana asifiwe. He spoke to me and he gave me an instruction. And that instruction, he told me, be doing it. Because out of it, I am going to shift you to another level. Bwana asifiwe. And what he commanded me to do, he gave me grace to do it. This is the reality. When God speaks to you, he releases grace. Tell your neighbor grace. What is grace? Grace is God empowering you to do something. Huh? The Bible says the grace of God has appeared to all men. So when you are hearing what I'm saying, the grace of God has entered you. So if you don't act upon that grace, then the word of God becomes of you. So every time we come here on this altar, Apostle has sung, Praise and Worship has sung, Reverend has done the announcements together with Pastor Teresa. We have heard so many things. Tumesikia mambo mingi. What God has done to you after hearing, he has released grace. Now it is for you to work on that grace. That grace is the divine enabler that is going to help you to pursue the word and to do it. The Bible says, do not only be hearers of the word, but also doers. Ongea na mtu siku ya leo. Am I helping somebody? Praise the name of the Lord. Thank you. So, when God speaks, you receive something called? Paul said, your grace I never took in vain, but I labored the more. Unajua kwa nini watu wana the same way, hawabadilikani? Wanakuanga kama ile inaitangwa kobole. Unakumbuka ile kitambo. Kuaga na tano. Tu abadiliki. Yesterday, they. Because they. The word of God. Grace enters them, but they never act through that grace. Hello? So, we can be prophesied to here by the woman of God. And she tells us it's our season of open doors. And grace enters your heart. But if you don't act on that grace, that word will only remain word. It will never become a reality. Somebody else will hear, it is your season of open doors. And grace enters their heart. And that person carries that word and activates the midnight hour. Wakati wengine wamelala, ako kwa magoti akiomba, my doors open. It was prophesied. I declare my doors open. Huyo mtu shortly will come back with a testimony. Yesu asifiwe. We have been told about this foundation. Pastor Teresa has announced on 12th we have a foundation here. Tumeambiwa kunahitajika mablanketi hapa. Praise the name of God. Tumeambiwa kuna mambo mengi ambayo tunafaa kufanya. We have all had. Oh, is the name of God. There are those ones who will say, foundation. They will do nothing. There are those ones who have heard and grace has entered their hearts. And they have begun some to have a burden. Kutakuwa na foundation. Na kumeitishwa blanket. Na inataka 1500. I feel the grace to give. I may not have the 1500 right now. But I can go and ask God in prayer. Lord, give me that I may. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And when you act on that grace, na utoke uende kazi, katikati ya hiyo shughuli, God give you the 1500, come and you bring the blanket. And then when the blessing is released for supporting the elderly through the foundation, the blessing comes on. That is why there are people in church who will always remain the same. Because they receive the word, the grace comes, but they never act on the grace. They remain. Yes, I am too. So there is a word that God gave the woman of God, and she shared yesterday online. And that is why I want to repeat it again, so that we may be blessed. Genesis chapter number 2, verse number 19. I don't know if Reverend can read for me. Chapter number 2, verse number 19. There are three prophetic things that Daktari said yesterday, and I want to build on those things in the name of Jesus. Genesis chapter 2, verse 19 to 20.
Genesis chapter number 2, verse number 19. Out of the ground, the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every bird of the air and brought them to Adam to see what he would call them. And whatever Adam called each living creature, that was its name. So Adam gave names to all cattle, to the birds of the air, and to every beast of the field. But for Adam, there was no found a helper comparable to him.
Hallelujah. There are two things I want you to get here. The Bible says, out of the ground, God formed every beast of the field and every bird of the air. The living creatures came from the ground. Number one. Every good thing will come from the ground. 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 We have visitors. Every good thing will come from the ground. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Tell your neighbor, make yourself a friend to the ground. Because every good thing will come from the ground. Bwana asifiwe. And that is why we began a topic which Bishop initiated. And she said, sexual error makes the ground to vomit you. Hallelujah. Leviticus 18 from verse number 24 to 25. It says, do not defile yourself in these things, referring to sexual error. For by so, I am removing the nations that were here before you, and the ground vomits them. Ongea na mtu. So every good thing comes from the ground. So you have work to do to make sure that you have healed your ground. You have become a friend to the ground. The ground has accepted you. The ground is producing good things for you. Ambia jirani, mchanga lazima ikukubali. Upende usipende. Changa lazima ifanye nini? Ikukubali. No matter how beautiful you are, no matter how many PhDs or doctorates you have, if the ground has not accepted you, you will remain a wanderer and a vagabond in life. Inua mkono wako, sema my father, any power, any mistake, any curse, any sin that defiled my ground and made me to be vomited, I command that evil to be erased by the blood of Jesus, 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 in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, oh ground, say, oh ground, ground, ground. Hear my word today. Accept me. Bring forth my goodness. Bring forth my treasures. Bring forth my abundance. Bring forth my finances. Bring forth my resources. Bring forth my overflow. Bring forth my increase in the name of. Read again verse 19.
Verse number 19.
I want you to hear well now.
Of Genesis chapter 2.
Yes.
Out of the ground.
Out of the ground.
The Lord God formed every beast of the field.
The Lord God formed every beast of the field.
And every bird of the air.
And every bird of the air.
And brought them to Adam to see what he would call them.
Hold there, Reverend. The Bible says out of the ground. Hallelujah. So where do you begin to create? From ground. Tell your neighbor, from the ground. You have to begin addressing your ground. And begin looking at your ground and analyzing your ground. And asking yourself, what is this apostle that is in my ground? That no matter how hard I work, I never seem to have progress or dominion in life. Ongea na mtu. Ni nini hii iko ndani ya mchanga wangu? Iko ndani ya ardhi yangu? Iko ndani ya nchi yangu? Ya kwamba hata niking'ang'ana kivipi, hata nikipanga pesa kivipi, hata nikijituma kibiashara kivipi, hata nikijikaza kimaisha kivipi, bado sikutani na mamlaka yangu, sikutani na baraka na utele. There is something in the ground. I've heard the word. Grace has entered you. Now, not afford to sleep for 8 hours when your ground is not. Ezi ingia kitana. Uamke 6 asubuhi na ardhi yako ni mbaya. Ongea na mtu. Uwezi afford kungorota na uwekelee duve tatu juu na ujigeuzange kwa kitanda usiku mzima and your ground is. You have to program your prayer life so much. You have to organize your prayer life so much. You have to have some days of fasting in the middle of the week so that you can address the ground. Even God never created a cow. Never created a warthog. Bwana asifiwe. He never said, let there be a warthog. No. He never said, let there be an anaconda. No. He went to the ground and formed them. So you have to visit your ground and form some things. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. You have to go to your ground and form your life. Form your career. Form your business. Form your destiny. Form your marriage. Form your next level. Because he who is accepted by the ground has dominion. Hello. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So you have to heal your ground. The Bible says out of the ground he formed the beast of the field. And all those things. Verse number 19, part B.
Part B of verse number is and brought them to Adam to see what he would call them.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever Adam called each living creature,
yes,
that was its name. So Adam gave names to all cattle, the birds of the air, mm-hmm, and to every beast of the field. Mm-hmm. But for Adam, there was not found a helper comparable to him.
Hallelujah. So there are two parts here. There is the part of God. There is the part of man. Pia jirani kuna sehemu mbili. Sehemu ya Mungu na sehemu yako. Na nitarudia tena. Wacha kuachia kuvita. Mungu nimekuachia yote. Mesubiri ushi. Utangoje, ungoje, ungoje, uzeeke, na ukufe ukingoja. Waandike kwa ile mawe inekagwa kwa kaburi. He died waiting. Praise the name of the Lord. Am I talking to somebody? Because there is the part of God and there is the part of man. God created and formed, brought to Adam. Kama Adam angenyamaza, sisi wote tungekuwa tunaitwa nameless. Nameless 1, nameless 2, nameless 3, nameless 4, nameless 5. Jua tungekuwa na nini? Majina. Praise the name of God. But Adam had to do a certain job. He had to give them names. This month, you are going to name some things in your life. This month, that was the prophecy Daktari released yesterday. You are going to name some things in your life. Kuna vitu utaziita na majina na zitafanyika vile katika jina la Yesu. The more you are going to name them, the more you are going to utter them, the more you are going to call them, the more you are going to command them, as you speak them, they will become so. In the name of Jesus. So I am naming my bank account millions. Hallelujah. Naming my bank account million. And I go deeper. I am naming myself a kingdom finance. When millionaires are called here to write checks to the church, mimi ni mmoja wao. Father, I am finance. Hallelujah. I am naming myself one of the owners of Range Rover 2024. It is possible. I am naming myself those who enjoy marriage. Yangu waita Isha Apostle. Aisha. Name it, call it, whatever you name it, it shall be so. That is why it is dangerous to keep quiet. Jiongeleshange hata ukiwa kwa washroom. Ukioga ka ukiongea tu. Bwana asifiwe. Juu wachawi wanaongeanga usiku na mchana. I met a certain man of a certain religion, ajijazia. Kwa mebeba tu vitu fulani. Baba mzee, kona heshima ya. Tembea tu. Kona, they have to, those two beads. You understand what I'm saying? They are ever talking. Look at how they are everywhere. Over this. They are in town, wamechukua ludhuli yote. They are in Karen. Juzi nilienda Muranga. Because they are speaking. They are naming things. They are taking over territories. Even you, begin to speak. Begin to talk. Begin to name your breakthrough. Father, I name 2024. The year of my promotion. The year of my lifting. The year of my wedding. The year of my car. The year of my house. The more you name it, it becomes so. Aje umelala peke yako kuna baridi kama petaje hapo Bwana asifi unaishingi tu hivyo peke yako kama post ya steam. Do you know how an electric post looks like? Inakaanga peke yake. Hiyo ingine inakuwaga imewekwa 25 meters away. Na wewe unaishi peke yako tu. And the world has 7 billion people. 7 billion. Uwezi pata moja hivi. One. Just one. Uliza jirani moja tu. And like now, the wicked, wale waovu, wakona waine. Akona main bibi, akona side chick, akona title deed. Hiyo mwingine ni nani? Mpoa, kuna mpermanent, kuna huyo mwingine mwallet, kuna mvisa, mdubai. Na wewe umeokoka, umejazwa na roho. Hata kusalimiwa haya, kuna. It's not good. Nambia jirani si sawa. E kama kikingi peke yako. Bible says two are better. One. Hallelujah. Are you blessed? Are you happy? This is the grace that Daktari came with from the mountain of prayer. So you have to name it. Tell your neighbor, name it. I remember when it was, Kenya was turning 50 years. Tukiingia Jubilee. You remember? It was 2013. Man here was crazy. She was crazy with faith because she named that year of going back to campus. Mwambia alisumbua doctor being the firstborn. Alimwambia mam lazima unipeleke. She named it her year of jubilee to enter into you. That same year, 2013, Pastor Teresa, she went to Desta. Her confessing and naming it made Bishop to get school fees. And Desta is not cheap. And she went through Desta for 4 years. And she finished and graduated. You can name this year 2024 your year where you will drive your car. Don't care how money will come. Just name it so and work it out. Kama mnapata ufunuo watu wa Mungu. You can name this year your year of opening your business. Kwa kazi mrefu. Kwa nini usifungue kodi konteka? Name it. June. My business. Call June the month of business. Call June the month of getting capital. I call June the month of setting up my own shop. I call June the month of increasing in customers. I call June. You can name it. You who has been desiring to go outside the country, you can name this year the year of visa. The Bible says, and God brought the animals to Adam to see what he would name them. And whatever he named them, they became so. Listen, God will respect the word of your mouth. Mungu ataheshimu maneno. Am I talking to somebody? Sami, name this year your year of entering. Unacheza hiki na hivi na umefungiwa tu hapa. Utakuwa unacheza Grace Chapel na unacheza Kamem. Unacheza Grace Chapel na unacheza Inoro. Unacheza Grace Chapel na unaonekana kwa runinga. Why? Because you named it to be so. Hallelujah. I remember when this year was starting, Bishop spoke very great things. He said, when I look at the kind of money and the vision I have, the money is too little. The vision. But, do it. Sasa ndio tumefika mwezi wa sita. The things she has, they are big. There is power in, honest, there is power in speaking. I want you to bow your head in. Point number. Ufunge macho yako. I want you to see the things you want to have. You tired of living in the ghetto? You tired of living in that small house? Are you tired of your bank balance 500 shillings? Are you tired of being a slave to other people? Are you tired of always being jobless? Are you tired of always telling people to send you help because you have nothing? Begin now to name this month of June your month of breakthrough. You are month of increase. You are month of abundance. You are month of multiplication. You are month of overflow. Begin to name it. This month of June, it is the month of helpers. It is a month of open doors. It is a month of divine connections. It is a month of the next level. It is a month of financial abundance. It is a month of being celebrated. It is a month of walking in dominion. It is a month of great grace. It is a month of more than enough. It is a month of new jobs, new opportunities, new breakthroughs. Begin to name it. Begin to call this month what you want it to see. If there are products that you sell, begin to name this month the month of selling more than enough. You are going to sell and sell and sell until your stock runs out. Begin to name this month a month of increase, a month of the next level. You who has been waiting for a job for a long time, name this month as the month of confirmation, of open doors, of being accepted in that job, of being sent an interview, of being erected into a place of being established. Begin to name this month a month of change of level, a month of more than enough, a month of great grace. You have lived in that house for a long time. You have struggled in that place for a long time. Name this month the month of shifting to a better home, to a better house, to a better estate, to a better location. The more you name what you shall call it, is what God shall follow it to be. In Jesus' name. Tell your neighbor, name it. 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 Where we live today, where we live, where I stay. I remember the state. Around 2000, I think, thereabout. The estate was very new. It was very good. I remember I went there with my sister and brother-in-law. Because I was looking at myself and the standard of that estate. Because the much I could have. Ndio ile pesa pale zinalipishwa pesa, but you know, while I was there, I remembered we were told we have to confess things, and ikajiambia kichini chini uko ndani yaibisha mbele ya watu chini chini ndani penda. Hey, 2 years living there. You can declare certain things, they will come to pass. Hallelujah. I remember, Apostle, I had desire, deep desire to drive a car. Wanaambia Mungu hata kama wagen kia. Ora tu nijionange kwa steering. And I remember even my friends would not allow steering. They would come and tell me, hey, yeah. They give me a lift. Alafu wananiacha mbali ndio nitembee. Bwana asifiwe. Do you know that desire, Apostle? It made me to download a game in. The altar. Yes, it done. Wags. Place to. Your game inaitwa Basi. And as I was driving that car in the game, I began to see my finger. I had a driving license in 2012. I just won a stamp, but it was just there. Driving, ever driven. Almost 10 years. I'm telling you the truth. The more I was driving that car in that phone, I was seeing myself on the road. Telling you the truth, the year 20 February. You can name some things and they will come. I remember a few weeks before the car came, I would wake up early in 5 prayer, begin to. This is my driving. Thank God that I am driving my. That is on a semi. But do you know God does not look at your balance to bless you? God's ways, not our ways. Unaweza kuwa unajiangalia unasema na hii kidogo ninaweza fanya. God is not looking at your kidogo. He is looking at your confession. If you can speak his word back to him, he will do his own things in his own way and ensure that which you have been waiting for comes to you. That year, I got it in the beginning of the year. So you can begin to name things. The 2 verse 6. The 2 verse 6. Why can you name some things and they come to be? Here is the answer. Psalms 82 verse 6. Psalms 82 verse 6.
Chapter 82 and verses number 6.
I want you to listen to this.
I said you are gods.
I said you are gods. Read it louder, Reverend.
I said you are gods.
Tell your neighbor, I said you are gods.
You are gods.
Tell your neighbor again, I said you are gods. Tell your neighbor, God said you are a god.
You are God.
Guy. Unaelewa hiyo kitu? Read again now.
I said you are gods.
Uh-huh.
And all of you are children of the Most High.
And all of you are children of the Most High. High. Thank you, Reverend. There are two parts here. You are all G, small O, small D, small S. Listen, when God calls you a God, it is not now wanze kuabudiwa. Worship you, Reverend Eric, give you honor. Is no, yo tusifanya, that is blasphemy. Bwana asifiwe. When the Bible says you are gods, it means this, kiza. It means the way God operates, you can operate like that. The way God makes things to happen, you can make them to happen. Let us make man in our image, according to our likeness. So if God spoke and it came to be, you can speak and it can come to be. Ah. If God said, let there be light, and there was light, you are a God. So you can say, let there be money, and money will look for you and come. Receive that grace to operate in the image and the likeness of God in the name of Jesus. A closed mouth is a closed destiny. It says, I said you. I said you are. You are. So I can look at my life and see dry bones. Ezekiel, can these dry bones live? Ezekiel tells God, only you. God does not take responsibility. Ezekiel, can these dry bones live? Ezekiel anarudisha kazi vile tunafanyanga bila kuelewa. Anaambia Mungu kuachia kazi ni wewe unajua. Mungu anamwambia unanirudishia kwa nini? Anamwambia professor to the dry bone. Are you getting the formula? Ezekiel, can these dry bones live? Ezekiel anaambia Mungu, sijui ni wewe tu unajua kurudishia vita. Mungu anamwambia dogashokerie nie, usinirudishie mimi. Prophesy. Ezekiel looks at a valley of dry bones. Begins to dry bones to life. The word of Ezekiel made the bones to begin to come to life. Fupa ya mguu inashikana na ya mguu inakuja shikana na hii, and the Bible says, and they became a mighty. I say to you, you are gods. Hallelujah. Ah, can we appreciate Daktari for getting such a powerful revelation? Tell your neighbor you are a god. So you can enter your house when it has nothing and declare, food, come forth. Designer bed, come forth. Electronics, come forth. Parking, have a car. You can declare, because you are gods. Tongue is very powerful. Job 22, Reverend, verse 20. Hizi ndio vitu daktari alifundisha. Ndio tunawaambianga ingeni kwa ile kipindi ya Torie. Ndio mpate hizi. Job 22:28. Ambia jirani usijidharau na usijichukie. Maneno yako yako na uzi. Bwana asifiwe. Job chapter number 22 verse 28.
Job
22.
Amen. I'm there. Job chapter number 22 verse number 28. Mm-hmm. You will also declare a thing.
You will also declare a thing. Tell your neighbor, my neighbor.
My neighbor.
You will declare a thing.
You will declare a thing.
Yes, Reverend.
And it will be established for you.
And it will be established for you. So your words are not empty words. When you declare a thing, it will be established for you.
Amen.
Ai, haujaelewa hiyo. When you declare a thing, God is so faithful to ensure that the words of his saints, the words of the small gods, shall be established. So you can stand in your family line and say, in this family, nobody will be poor again.
Amen.
And it shall be established. Amen. And light?
So light will shine on your way.
When you begin to release words, light comes. Mahali apostle panaonekana ni kama kuna giza, hakuna mwelekeo na hakuna vitu zinaonekana zinapatikana. When you begin to declare, light begins to come. You have been in that valley for a long time. You have been in that situation for a long time. You have remained in that calamity for a long time. It is true your father's altars are fighting you. It is true the foundations of your mother's house are delaying you. It is true bloodline curses are interfering with you. But you can rise with power and declare, "Oh, ye altars of my father's house, hear me and hear me well. You shall not fight me. You shall not delay me. Lose me and let me go." Ye shall also declare a thing, and it shall be established. Do you know what establishment means? Establishment, Shiko, is like the Kenyan constitution. Unaenda kinyume na constitution ya Kenya. Unaenda kinyume na constitution. No matter who you are, no matter how many followers you have, no matter where you are born, enda kinyume katiba ya Kenya, uone vile kitakuwa. Talking to someone. So that is establishment. That constitution has been seated down by governors, senators, members of parliament, people in law. They have sat down and they have written laws in that constitution that govern our nation. And anybody who goes against that law that has been established, that person is condemned to judgment. So there are things you are going to declare, and God is going to establish them. And any demon that is going to come and try to go against what you have said, there shall be judgment on their heads. So you can declare in your life, "I will never be poor." And any demon of poverty that cries to come near me, angels of God deal with it. The Bible says, "And light shall shine on your way." Verse number 29. Yes.
When they cast you down.
When they cast you down. Nambia jirani wakikushusha. Wakikuleta chini. Hear what the Bible says.
And you say exaltation will come.
And you say exaltation. Hey guy. Guy. Na urumia maadui zenu. Wakati watajaribu kukushusha wakueke chini, hautangangana nao, hamtashinda mkipelekana kwa askari, utasema siezi kaa chini, I am exalted. Read.
Then he will save the humble person.
And he will save the humble person. Listen to this. If there is anybody in your family that is not born again, hajaokoka, sahi.
Verse number 30.
Yes.
He will even deliver one who is not innocent.
He will even deliver one who is not innocent.
Yes. He will be delivered by the purity of your hands.
He will be delivered by the purity of your hands. Ule ndugu yako anakunywanga pombe, analala kwa mtaro. Ule dada yako analewangwa, anafanya mambo haijielewi. Yule baba yako ambaye amefungwa na mambo na amekataa Mungu. The Bible says, even those who are not innocent shall be delivered by the words of your mouth. So you can stand in your family and declare, "Everybody called by my name in this family shall be born again, shall be set free, shall be liberated, shall be delivered, shall come to the knowledge of the truth." Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So your husband, mwenye anakulilisha kila siku, carry his salvation in your lips. Weza simama kwa hiyo nyumba na hii ufunuo. Mwambie Mungu, "I am a small God. The same power that nimetangaza mzee akataliwe na ba." Praise the name of God. "Nimetangaza watoto wangu wakataliwe na bangi. Nimeweka uadui katikati yao na mihadarati. Nimeweka uadui katikati yao na usherati. Nimeweka uadui katikati yao na njia za dunia. Nimetangaza kwa ajili ya kinywa changu waokoke, wakombolewe na wafunguliwe." And I'm telling you the truth. Your words will make them to come to church. How do you think our deacon Daniel went to Pastor Trees came? Sasa ziwaambie, ilikuwa kimekuramba. Zee alikuwa anakunywa na huyu deacon unaona ngapa ametulia. Very humble man, hana ubaya. Hadi alifungwa jela miaka. Kwa jela miezi. Miezi alikuwa jela. Huyu deacon mnaona. Praise the name of God. Na harusi bado iko tunafanya. Yo mjue Mungu ataheshimisha maneno ya kinywa chako. Pastor Teresa came, he had uncommon faith. Pastor Mary, you are there, you. Reverend, you are there. Alikuwa na imani ingine ya kawaida. Ndiye alikuwa ameingia tu kanisani. Akakuja akatuambia, kuna mzee lakini si mzuri sana. But I have faith. Do you know declaration? A faith, a submission to the anointing. Ilifanya deacon mimi sijui alitokea wapi. Akakuja akainua mikono akaokoka. Today our man is a deacon. He is the driver wa daktari hapa. I think next week Wednesday ndiye akona Bible study hapa. A man mwenye alikuwa anakunywa, alikuwa analala kwa mitaro. Asubuhi chai yake ilikuwa pombe. Asubuhi chai yake ni pombe, jioni umuokote kwa mita. Huyo ndio sasa namuona kwa online anaitwa Daniel Munga. Iko. Because you can declare a thing, it shall be established. Watu wa Mungu, si story na wapigia. Hizi si tunawaambia tupitishe masaa. We are not acting. We are not trying to be religious people. No. We are coming to create. You shall also declare thing and it shall be established for you. Number two. So that was point number one. Number two. Job chapter number 20 verse number 15. These are the things that Daktari had while she was in the mountain of.
Job chapter number 30 verse 30 number 13.
2015.
Yes. He swallows down riches.
He swallows down riches.
And vomits them up again.
And vomits them up again.
God cast them out of his belly.
God cast them out of his belly. Number two thing that Daktari received from the mountain. God told her, chochote chako ambacho kilimezwa na mdomo wa shetani, kinaenda kutapikwa katika jina la Yesu. Any swallowed blessing, any swallowed inheritance, any swallowed opportunity, any swallowed marriage, any swallowed thing that the devil swallowed from your life, the Bible has said, it shall be vomited. Tell your neighbor, it shall be vomited. I want you to read verse 14 and see something. Verse 14.
Yet his food in his stomach turns. Can I start verse 12 so that we get the flow? Mm-hmm. Though evil is sweet in his mouth, and he hides it under his tongue, though he spares it and does not forsake it, but still keeps it in his mouth, yet his food in his stomach turns sour. It becomes cobra venom within him.
Lisa, in the realm of the spirit, there are stomachs. Ya na mtu. Kama kuna wakati, ushaienda Pastor Teresa, a lot of work, gathered money. Kini ukijaribu kupigia hiyo pesa hesabu. Unajiuliza, hadi una download statement ya M-Pesa just to make sure your pesa may have experienced that. You've gone through that. You cannot really account hii pesa imeenda aje. Ulikuwa nayo lakini ni kama imeenda na maji. Have you experienced that thing? And you try to wonder, how have I spent this money? How did it end so fast? How am I now going to get a loan? Sasa unaenda kukopa, kufuliza, kuingia kwa hizi loan app, ndio ukope pesa, na yet, masaa ingine ulikuwa nayo. Have you experienced such a thing? There are mouths that do what? But the Bible has said, I will make what you have swallowed to become our venom. Stomachs. Ni kumaanisha maadui zako kile walimeza kitaanza kufanya kitaanza kuwasokotesha tumbo, kitaanza kuwasumbua, wataanza kugeuka kwa viti, wanaanza kushindwa, mbona hatuna amani, mbona tunasumbuka hivi? Because what they have swallowed that belongs to you, they must vomit in the name of Jesus. Inua mkono wako, sema, my father, my father. Chochote kilimezwa na maadui zangu, na wachawi na waganga, na wale unitakia mabaya, na tangaza siku ya leo, kitapikwe, 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 tapikisha nyota, tapikisha ndoa, tapikisha watoto, tapikisha fedha, tapikisha biashara, tapikisha chochote, shetani alimeza, waganga walimeza, wachawi walimeza, maadui wa maisha yako walimeza, leo katika jina la Yesu, lazima watapike, lazima watapike. Tangaza tumbo zao zianze kusokota, tangaza tumbo zao zianze kuwasumbua, tangaza kile walimeza kifanyike moto ndani ya tumbo zao, hakita wafaidi, hakita baki na wao, watakitapika, watapike afya, watapike maono, watapike watoto, watapike hiyo ndoa waliobeba wakaribu, watapike biashara walioimeza, watapike maisha yako, watapike. Command them to vomit, let them vomit anything they swallowed, anything they took, anything they ate, anything they chewed, called by your name, let it be vomited, let it be vomited. My glory in the bellies of my enemies, be vomited, be vomited. Stand up on your feet, begin to declare, whatever they swallowed, they shall vomit. Lay your hands on your belly, tangaza, chochote walimeza, wanatapika leo, wanatapika leo. Mahali ulipo, sio kiwango yako, sio sehemu yako, sio maono yako. There is bigger, there is better, but your blessings were swallowed today, today, in the name of Jesus. Whatever they swallowed, let them vomit, let them vomit. My star, be vomited out of the belly of my enemies. My glory, my children, my health, my career, my destiny, in the belly of witches, of sorcerers, of diviners, of ancestral altars, be vomited, 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 in the name